champion coming through.
Hello, Lucan. I'd like to practice with the training dummy.
Excellent idea. This time will be a bit more of a challenge. Ready?
That'd be brilliant.
Wonderful. I'll set things up. Remember to cast all the spell combinations before the dummy lands again. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know.
Accio! Incendio! Levioso!
Excellent form! Good one!
Accio! Incendio! Levioso! Accio! Incendio!
Nicely done! Impressive wand work. I'd hate to face you in a duel.
It was only a training dummy.
True, but it's a difficult dummy. Believe me, I know. Seriously, well done. Training dummies will think twice before challenging you again. Plus, you'll be even more formidable in crossed wands. Other duelers had better beware.
Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of crossed wands ready?
Big match today. It all comes down to this. The moment that we find out if your training and dedication is enough to win it all. Ready for a shot at glory?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
Yes, Sebastian.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
Fringo!
Oh, there goes my wager.
Sendo!
You're better than that!
Fringo!
That was nothing. I'm just getting started.
If the best duelists in the school weren't enough competition, then perhaps you should consider transferring to Durmstrang. Now, to the victor goes the prize! And so it is my great honor to present you with this simple yet elegant token of supreme dueling accomplishment.
Thank you. It's been an honor.
You earned it. You are a duelist to be reckoned with. Now that we've definitively crowned the tournament winner, I suppose I should get back to my schoolwork. Wonder how my herbology plants are doing. I haven't tended them in ages.
Yes.
I hope you were able to take care of everything I had asked you to do.
Professor, I completed all of your most recent assignments.
Well done. Then you're ready to learn Expelliarmus. Pay close attention. The disarming charm may often be all you need to defeat the most powerful dark witches and wizards you might encounter. Spellcasting requires a focused mind and a steady wand. Good work. The dummy is here if you wish to stay in practice.
Expelliarmus!
You seem to have the right end of the stick, but keep practicing. Expelliarmus may save your life one day.
Again.
Good morning, Professor Garlick. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Oh, hello. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio. Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug. Should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone! Now, for our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables. You can all get...
I wonder if hippogriffs like not grass.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
I'll say. Nearly went deaf.
Well, yes. Of course, the cry of a mature mandragora can be fatal, so remember to keep those ears protected. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement. Niffler's Fancy or Roses?
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganwell potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class. Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganwell potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage. You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. I'm Leander. I'll be showing you the Chinese chomping cabbages. Up these stairs will take us there. But your lead. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh. Well. Thank you.
I nearly... Here we are. Revelio. Home of the Chinese chomping cabbage. Go on. Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest. Look at that. They'll chomp on anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out.
Revelio.
Gnoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that just have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
Trust me, Leander. I was imagining it the entire time.
You were? I mean, of course, you're not someone to be trifled with. I see that. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
That. And with that helpful reminder as to why we should always wear our dragon hide gloves,
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Thank you, Professor. But looking after plants isn't all that thrilling to me.
I think you'll come to see that the fruit is well worth the labour. As we herbologists like to say, tend to your plants and they'll tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wiganweld potion.
Mr. Takar,
Can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wiganweld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wiganweld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumors of a goblin rebellion.
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
Yes, but why does that matter to you?
Brilliant! And it matters because you can be a part of something truly creative. I'm Gareth, by the way. Gareth Weasley. Bit of a prodigy with potions, if I do say so myself.
Pleasure to meet you. Wait, are you related to Professor Weasley?
She's my aunt. Keeps too close an eye on me for comfort. Ugh. But she can't be everywhere. Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single Fwooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'll get you the Fwooper feather, as long as you're certain Sharp won't miss it.
I assure you he won't. Fwooper feathers aren't that valuable. Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
A well-prepared... Precision is key when brewing potions.
Here's the Fwooper feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you! This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Edurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Should you chop the dittany or crush it? The wrong answer could result in the unfortunate loss of your eyebrows.
And now we add the mallow sweet, and... that's odd. What's happening? Wait, it's not supposed to. Ah!
Get it!
Oh! Dragon dog! What happened?
Well done, Gareth.
What now, Mr. Weasley?
Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor. Again. Mr. Weasley did not do this on his own. his accomplice will answer to me as well.
I brewed an Adurus potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm not sure what you're talking about, Professor.
You will not earn favor with me by failing to take responsibility for your actions. I suggest you heed my warning. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day. Class is dismissed.